Well, not the perfect phosphor frequency, but it'll do. I need to cool the transformer. Top the device, or the whole thing will overheat. I need to actually use Old Man Winter on the transformer. Okay, that should stop it from overheating. There, everything's fixed. We're ready.
Let's fire it up and see.
Again.
Booker, look, we're on the First Lady. It can't be this easy. The First Lady Mark II was built around a particle lift system, just like all the buildings in the city. I read all about it in the Columbian Scientific. The particle seated at the top of the structure. Must be up that lift. Perfect.
Seems like a lot of technology just to float an airship. Comstock never heard of hydrogen.
The First Lady Mark I did run on hydrogen. And it was destroyed by a single bullet from a Vox sniper. Unfortunately, the Prophet wasn't on board at the time. Take the active particle, then the First Lady is just a 40-ton paperweight. Here we go. Now let's head back through that tear.
You honestly expect Atlas to honor his side of the deal?
No, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it.
How do you plan on handling Atlas? He ain't just some spliced-up maniac.
He'll make a mistake. I just have to be ready to take advantage of it.
Girl you barely know.
How well did you know me when you came to Columbia? Nothing but trouble that way. Best to head straight back to Rapture.
Pretty lady not finished yet.
What? Open the tear.
Power for devices, very expensive. Need for that?
Just tell me what you want.
So Jung wanted something as simple. Lock of hair.
Oh, you're not serious.
Not your hair, stupid. Fink has a secret lab. Mothballed, forgotten. In there, hair sample. In jar. Cannot miss it. You get for Sutron. Then everybody friends.
Where is his lab?
Closed off, past Fink's quarters. You smart lady, you fine.
Should have seen that one coming.
Vox Populi. You must have arrived right in the middle of...
Either you and I are probably inside the factory, on our way up to the First Lady.
And what happens if we run into ourselves?
We won't.
How do you know that?
Because we didn't.
me good service, but I will not hurt the boy. I will see Fink and Comstock burn, but I will not hold the son to account for the deeds of his father.
You've misunderstood us.
We neither asked you to harm the child.
Nor did we promise that yours would be the hand that would set Comstock's world afire.
A famous man once said...
And a famous man shall say...
I may reach the mountaintop...
But I fear I shall never visit the valley below.
But you mean I won't live to see the... No.
It's up to you what matters more.
Your part in the play.
Or the play itself.
Someone is coming.
She'll arrive, a girl.
She must leave, a woman.
And what makes the difference between a girl and a woman?
Blood.
Your part in the play.
Or the play itself.
Turn her into a killer? How?
Give the girl no choice.
And she will be forced to make one.
Oh, so she wasn't evil. Well, not really. She did that on purpose. Well, it would have seemed that she would have done that, but... Had enough events. Tired of calling it events. Do the Ironsides thing. Okay, no, I'm not doing it. No. Because I don't know what this is. No, I'm not doing this again. No. I don't know what you think this was. What you thought this was. Thank you.
my dear brother, these holes in the thin air continue to pay dividends. I know not which musician you borrow your notes from, but if he has half the genius of the biologist I now observe, well, then you are to be the Mozart of Columbia.
Hide from me!
Yeah?
Yeah, there's a war coming. You can smell it in the air. Fear, hatred, people dying every day. But how many more will suffer if we rise up? Violence begets violence, I know this. I've seen this. The rational mind argues for a peaceful solution to find a common ground, but what common ground is there to find for a father who watches his child bleed out in the street? How'd he deny him his vengeance? I know that fire that burns deep inside. I know it all too well. And when the time comes, will I be able to stay the hand?
Mechanism unlocks certain activities when Fink gives us blessing.
So what? We're stuck waiting for the cuckoo to go off?
No, there's a slot for some kind of key for Manuel Weimer. We just gotta find that.
Sure seems like a lot of work to lock down a few doors.
Yeah, well, if there's one thing Fink loves, it's a lot of work.
State of being, or lack thereof, has left my brother unfulfilled.
We've got the clock key.
Our current state of being, or lack thereof, has left my brother unfulfilled. The biological urge to leave one's mark is strong, and it is not an impossibility. We could instantiate ourselves back in Columbia. Return to an old life for the possibility of creating new. But we died in that world. Returning would mean giving up part of us. Ourselves. We'd become flesh and all that it is heir to. The mysteries of the universe would become once again mysteries.
Inconvenient fuel for his plasmids? If there is a god, and I've seen more evidence to the contrary than in support, you'd think he'd have put Adam into the belly of a nice little seagull or crow. The cost of all these underwater expeditions are murdering my margins.
As to the matter of religion, let me place myself in the camp of the agnostic. I pretend to understand the mysteries of the infinite no more than you, Comstock, or anyone else for that matter. But for the sake of argument, let's say this is all one unhappy accident, and we all alone in our toils. Then who would Comstock use to control and shame us with rules that apply only to those with not a penny in their pocket? If there were no God, you could rest assured the first deed done by the first rich man would be inventing him.
I got you your gun. I'm here for my issue.
But my Booker DeWitt died for the Vox Populi. You either an imposter or a ghost. My Booker DeWitt was a hero to the cause, a story to tell your children.
Humor me then? Please.
I think Booker would miss you.
Cool. Jesus! It's right in here! Say, somebody, fetch me a millionaire to clean this mess up!
Damn, Nick. It must have slipped wrong.
Hey!
Ride up!
Gonna hunt you down!
Comstock promises there's nothing to be worried about, but I don't like the smell of things down in Finkton. Not one bit. If trouble rears its ugly head in the form of one cantankerous negress, I've laid in some supplies in the event of a forced evacuation. They're down in what I call my Chamber of Panic, near the base of my statue. I've set the code to 8371.
Shut down! Kill her!
There's no surviving this.
She is snoring.
There's been some concern about the nature of the work we do here at Fink Manufacturing. Why, some say they're uncomfortable with the purported harm and suffering our research brings. But friends, let me pose a simple question. Is there anything you would not do to guarantee the health and safety?
Hair sample in a haystack.
Getting to the foxes are afraid of the hens. If Fink was going to hire a bunch of goons to keep an eye on the handymen, he should have found someone less yellow in the belly. Now they're hiding away from Tin Man invalids in their precious little guard room. If you need to get in there on your shift, the code is 2847.
Who done this? Someone about?
Thank you. When I find you, then...
What?
A killer.
Yeah, well, mission accomplished. I'm no martyr. How did you do it, Booker? How did you...
Elizabeth, I'm not Booker.
And neither am I.
Fun?
I can smell ya. You're afeard of me.
You are right.
That's it.
I'm coming for you. Here I come. To arms, brothers! Find her! Hunt you down! Where are you? When I find you, you're not a lion! Down. Little pig. Where did she go? Oh, escape, pig.
Mm-hmm.